Our Father, which art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, ever. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
So, we are here this morning for a joyous morning.
Yay!
To kill that old self. You know? Keep on.
There we go.
Keep on. Come down to me. So we're going to bury that old self. You know, but first, we have to get into... Give you a few specifics as to why you need to do this, and because it's a very important undertaking, something that we take lightly. So we're gonna get a scripture. We have to use scriptures. So we're gonna start in 1 John 3. Transgresseth also the law, for sin is the transgression of the law. Sin is the transgression of the law, and we have all fall short of that. Because what we were told back in the day, before we know the laws and commandments, hey, sin is no drinking, no smoking, and little finger. But sin is actually the transgression of the law, and we just started to learn the law a few years ago. So I'm guaranteed that we all were not following this law that these books are not. That is written in this scripture. So we have our fault in short of that. Let's have Romans 3. Pick it up at 23.
Does that make it
then? Okay. Verse 22. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. As I said before, all have sinned and come short of the glory. Because we didn't know this law. We are not Christ. Christ is the only perfect man to walk. Right?
Being justified freely by His grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. Whom God had set forth to be a propitiation through faith in His blood, to declare His righteousness for the remission of sins that are passed through the forbearance of God.
So, through the faith in Jesus Christ, we have an option, we have a chance to be redeemed from our sinful nature that we were born into. Through that blood of Christ that is provided to us, we have an option to be in the kingdom, to remit a past sin that, you know, we have committed. So Christ gives us that option. Go on to Romans 6. Let me get there, start at 1.
What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound?
No.
God forbid.
Because not because we have grace that means we continue in sin. You know, we can't continue sinning willfully. We know what is right. We know what the law says now. We know what is sin. So, we shall not continue in sin anymore. Right?
God forbid. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? Know ye not that so many of us as were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into His death? Therefore we are buried with Him by baptism into death, that like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in newness of life.
Yes, so when we go under this walk today and we come up, we're coming up, we're burying that old self, and we come up in newness of life. walking in Christ. Right.
For if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall be also in the likeness of his resurrection. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin.
Once you come out of this world and now it's a new man, serving sin no more. All right, so, we say it's a commitment. So we have to go to now, go to Mark 16. And we're going to pick that up at verse 15.
And he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature.
Every creature.
He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned.
Alright, so once you hear this word and you believe, the culmination of that belief now is to baptize and show the world that yes, I'm now walking in that newness. So if you don't do it, if you don't hear the word and believe, then your options are very limited for the later path. So this is what we have to ask you now. So you're here and it's a commitment that we have to make. We have to ask you now. Are you ready to be committed and be under the blood? Jesus Christ. Alright. So we need to get into that water now. We're going to start with planting.
Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from the western side of the island. This is our new member, Franklin. They're going as we enter the water.
Alright. Our merciful Father, we come before you this morning and present to you Franklin Allen as a living sacrifice to your God. We ask you, dear God, as you accept him, dear Father, as a new disciple, as you baptize him in your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, for passing, for remission of past sins.
Woo! Woo! Yeah! The new creature, all things are passed away! Give a hand. Cause right there says a drop.
It's fine. I have to tell you. What name do you want to be called? Give me a name.
Celebrating Forest Garden.
Oh, merciful Father, once again I present to you Celebrating Forest Garden as a disciple, as a living sacrifice, Lord. Ask you, dear God, that you accept your Father as a new disciple, as a baptizer in your beloved Son Jesus Christ's name for remission of past sins.
Yes, ma'am.
Woo!
New creature, new commitment, right
new
there.
Sally. New Sally.
Come on, songbird.
Come on, Mona.
Yep, songbird.
Merciful Father, once again, I present to you another disciple, Ramona Brown, as a living sacrifice, Lord. Father, we ask you, dear God, that you accept her as a new disciple, as we baptize her in your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in our mission of past years.
All the way. Woo! Thank you, God. New disciple right there, Jesus.
Yeah,
man, she went under, so all the way. So we rise as new beings, new creatures. Amen.
Yeah.
Hug time, hug time, hug time.